In this video, we will discuss the critical importance of precise system charge level. As you can see from this graph, the average system refrigerant charge amount has been reduced dramatically since the mid-1980s. In fact, the average vehicle today uses only about half the amount of refrigerant used in 1990. In other words, the efficiency of systems has doubled in order to get the same job done with only half the amount of refrigerant. This doubling of efficiency has been accomplished by dramatic improvements in system and components design, especially of evaporators and condensers. Here is how a refrigerant undercharge can result in catastrophic compressor failure. PAG oil does not dissolve in R-130 for a refrigerant, it simply mixes with it. Oil circulation in the system is dependent on the presence of enough liquid refrigerant to carry the oil around. This is especially important in the evaporator, where the refrigerant enters the bottom as a liquid and exits the top as a gas. It is essential that the liquid refrigerant level in the evaporator remains high enough to ensure that oil is carried up and out of the evaporator and returns to the compressor. If the system is undercharged, the oil, which does not evaporate, separates from the gaseous refrigerant and drops to the bottom of the evaporator. Now, only pure refrigerant, which by itself is a powerful degreaser, returns to the compressor. This washes down the vital lubricating film of oil from the compressor pistons and cylinder walls. With no lubrication, the compressor starts to wear and fails rapidly. The end result, of course, is the dreaded comeback. And it's not just the compressor that will have failed. The entire system will be recontaminated with debris and components that may have just been replaced as part of the original repair will have to be replaced again and the rest of the system completely flushed. A system overcharge, on the other hand, can result in equally catastrophic compressor damage by liquid locking or slugging the compressor. A liquid cannot be compressed, therefore any liquid entering the compressor can result in irreparable damage. Because the compressor is a significant source of noise and vibration, many manufacturers have mounted it low down in the engine bay as far away from the occupants as possible. Now any excess liquid, either refrigerant or oil, can easily drain down into the low-mounted compressor, causing catastrophic slugging. It is not uncommon to see broken reed valves or even a cracked case due to slugging. For these reasons, it is vital that the system is charged with exactly the correct amount of refrigerant following compressor replacement, or even as part of a routine air conditioning service. Undercharging results in a failure from lack of lubrication. Overcharging results in failure due to slugging. Here are some tips for accurate refrigerant charging. Be sure that you know the correct charge specification for the vehicle you are working on. This is usually available on the underhood refrigerant decal. Your electronic repair information will also have capacity specifications. It is also a good idea to check for OE manufacturers' technical service bulletins, as system refrigerant and oil charge specifications are sometimes revised to address issues that arise in the field. Do not use cans. Cans get cold as the refrigerant evaporates, and it is difficult to get the heat of the can into the system. Several ounces may remain in the can, resulting in an undercharge. Check that your equipment meets the current SAE specification for recovery recycling recharging machines. For R134A machines, a decal on the machine should indicate that it meets SAE J2788. During charging, follow all on-screen prompts. J2788 machines are designed to compensate for the length of the refrigerant hoses. The machine may prompt you to close the high side service coupling and run the AC system to ensure that all the refrigerant in the lines is drawn into the system. When possible, always charge to the high side service port. Some machines will insist on this, and some may give you the option of charging through either the high or low side service port or both. Charging through the high side port greatly reduces the risk of slugging the compressor on initial startup following charging. Maintain your equipment. Check the charging scale calibration periodically and check the machine for leaks, especially the service couplings. Finally, if system components, such as the condenser, have a significantly different internal volume from the OE unit removed from the vehicle, it may be necessary to adjust the system charge level to optimize performance to match the new condenser. A differential temperature test, sometimes called a maximum heat load test, is the best way to fine-tune the charge level. Thank you for watching.